Is your Windows computer not booting with second hard drive plugged in? Then you are at the right place, as we have the solutions for you to fix this issue. Let's get started. This is the Windows Club. If your Windows 11 or 10 computer won't boot with a second hard drive plugged in, then first make sure the drive is working properly and there are no issues with it. Most Windows 11 or Windows 10 computers are configured to boot from their C or system drive. However, if your system is connected to a second hard drive and you find it will not boot, under these circumstances, this video will help you. Let's get started. Method 1. Check connections physically. It's quite possible that you left a loosened cable while installing the new hard drive. To check this, it's important to shut down your computer completely to avoid any electrical hazards or damage to the components. Next, disconnect your PC from the power source to ensure there is no electrical current flowing through the system while you work on it. Now, carefully remove the side panel of your computer case. This usually involves unscrewing or sliding off the panel. Check the cables. A hard drive mainly has two cables, SATA and power. SATA cable is the data cable that connects your hard drive to the motherboard, allowing data transfer between them. It's typically a thin, flat cable with an L-shaped connector at the end. Make sure the SATA cable is firmly connected to both the hard drive and the motherboard. A loose connection can prevent the BIOS from detecting the drive. Next is your power cable. This cable supplies power from the power supply unit or PSU to your hard drive. Check that the power connector is snugly attached to the hard drive. It's usually a wider connector with multiple pins and may have a slight clip to secure it in place. If either of them is not connected well or loose, the BIOS won't recognize the drive and the computer won't be able to use it for booting. Method 2. Change boot sequence. To change the boot sequence, you need to boot into the BIOS and check the boot order. The key to enter BIOS varies from motherboard to motherboard. So check your manufacturer's user manual or website to know the exact process. The basic process is, when starting your computer, you can continue pressing the right key for your system to enter the UEFI or BIOS. The right key for your system could be F1, F2, F10, etc. And it depends on your manufacturer. You may be able to see which key in the bottom left or right side of your boot screen when your computer is booting. You can check this guide for details. You can also press Win plus I to open settings. Then go to the System tab and select Recovery. Then click on Restart Now button against Advanced Startup. When you click on Restart Now, it will reboot your PC and offer you all these advanced options. Click and wait till you get these options. Select Troubleshoot, then Advanced Options. The screen offers further options which include System Restore, Startup Repair, Go Back to the Previous Version, Command Prompt, System Image Recovery, and UEFI Firmware Settings. Select UEFI Firmware Settings and it will let you restart your PC. Once the computer boots up, it will take you to the Firmware Settings. Switch to Boot tab. Here, you will see Boot Priority, which will list connected hard drive, CD or DVD, ROM, and USB drive if any. Now, if USB is ranked higher in the boot sequence, it can cause this problem. You will experience a similar issue when you will try to connect other USB hard drive to your PC. So, make sure to move USB HDD or USB below the original hard drive. You can use the arrow keys or plus and minus on your keyboard to change the order. Save and exit. You can follow this guide to know in details. Thereafter, reboot and check if the issue is resolved. Method 3. Delete boot.ini files. Connect your external hard drive to a different computer and launch File Explorer to check for any hidden files in the root directory. For instance, the presence of a boot.ini file may cause Windows to treat your USB as a bootable device. If you find such a file, remove it to prevent the drive from being recognized as a boot device. Sometimes, copying files from one computer or device to another can inadvertently transfer hidden system files to your external drive, which might lead to errors. Method 4. Update HDD drivers. Update your device drivers to the latest versions available. To do that, right-click on the Start button, select Device Manager. Here, you can uninstall, disable, roll back or update device drivers. Now identify the driver you want to update. For example, here we will opt to update the USB driver. So locate the Universal Serial Bus Controller and double-click on it to expand it. You will see various USB drivers installed. Select the one you want to update and right-click on it. The menu will show you the option to update driver. Select it. You may opt for either one of these options, search automatically for updated driver software, or browse my computer for driver software. It is recommended to select search automatically for updated driver software and let Windows identify, download, and install the driver. If an update is found, Windows will download and install it. Or select search for updated drivers on Windows Update. If you have the driver file on your computer, you can select Browse My Computer for driver software. Select the driver software file on your hard disk and click OK to proceed. There is another way. You can right-click on the driver and select Properties. Click Open the Driver tab and you will see the button to update driver. You can use this way too. You may also download the drivers directly from the manufacturer's website. You can follow this guide to update device drivers and this guide to download the drivers from the manufacturer's website. Once done, restart your PC. Method 5. Run Hardware and Devices Troubleshooter. Connect the hard drive to another Windows 11 or 10 computer and run Hardware and Devices Troubleshooter and see. It will automatically check for and fix problems if any. On Windows 11, you can run the troubleshooter using command prompt. Here is how to do so. Type CMD in the Windows search box and choose to run command prompt as an administrator. Click on Yes from the USC prompt. Now type or copy and paste msdt.exe-id, device diagnostic, and hit Enter. Click on the next button to run the troubleshooter. Complete the process and then check. You can also follow this guide to run the troubleshooter. Method 6. Run Startup Repair. If your Windows fails to load or if it starts up but crashes, try running automatic repair. It fixes most of the Windows 11 or 10 boot problems. This will let you start Windows from an external device, change Windows startup settings, or restore Windows from a factory image. To carry out startup repair in Windows 11, you need to boot to the Advanced Startup Options screen. Open Windows 11 Settings, go to System, then select Recovery on the right side. In the next screen under Recovery Options, you will see Advanced Startup. Click on the Restart Now button to initiate the process. From the WinRE screen, select Troubleshoot, then select Advanced Options. Under Advanced Options, select Automatic or Startup Repair. Windows Automatic Repair will now begin to identify and resolve the problem. This process may take some time and your system may even boot. Once the process completes successfully, you will see a message. For details, you can follow this guide. So that's it. Subscribe to the Windows Club for all your tech solutions related to Windows. Thanks for watching.